Dissecting the case involving Maria Ressa of Rappler. In her press conference after the guilty verdict had been handed down by the court, Maria Ressa was adamant, believing that the government of President Rodrigo Duterte was behind the case against her in an attempt to silence her and those criticizing the government of President Duterte. She believed and stated it was meant to curtail press freedom and nothing but an effort to instill fear among the critics of government and a blow to the spirit of democracy in the Philippines. In raising the concept of press freedom, Maria Ressa, whether she intended it or not, was actually invoking Article 3, Section 4 of the Philippine Constitution, which is copied from the U.S. Constitution, and states, "No law shall be passed abridging the freedom of speech, of expression, or of the press, or the right of the people peaceably to assemble and petition the government for redress of grievances." At first glance, Article 3, Section 4 seems to favor Ms. Maria Ressa and her political stand on the issue. Actually, the law does favor Ms. Maria Ressa, and in truth, there really is no law in the Philippines banning Maria Ressa or stopping her, or anyone for that matter, for writing whatever they want to write about or expressing whatever they want to express, provided that they are within the bounds of law, or in layman's term, as long as they are within lawful acts. But when someone freely expresses him or herself by burning and destroying public properties, then that is still within their freedom of expression, but falls within the crime of arson or even rebellion. Then the act becomes a crime and an unlawful act. In the same manner, journalists and investigative reporters can freely write anything under the sun, even slander and defame the integrity and reputation of any individual, provided their allegation can stand the test of truth in the court of law. It is because the Constitution does not only provide freedom of speech, of expression, and of the press, but also and moreover, it also guarantees equal protection of the law for every citizen. Section 1 of the same article, or Article 3, provides this, for which no person shall be deprived of life, liberty, or property without due process of law, nor shall any person be denied the equal protection of the laws. In the case of Maria Ressa and her writer Ray Santos Jr., since the online article written in 2012 and edited in 2014 maligned and put in bad light the reputation of the individual Wilredo Keng, the Constitution under Article 3, Section 1 gives right to Mr. Keng to equally be protected under the auspices of the law by filing a criminal case against the writers of the said article, which to him damaged his reputation. Perhaps because Maria Ressa is partly an American, she was holding to the First Amendment of the U.S. Constitution, which falsely gives the notion of the absolute freedom of the press being immune from lawsuits. Yet, that is false, because every now and then, defamation lawsuits springing from slanderous articles crop up once in a while in local courts in the U.S. The U.S. Supreme Court is relegated to allowing them to be, with the principle that the best shield against defamatory lawsuits is nothing but the truth. In short, true statements cannot be defamatory. So now, how can the truth be ferreted out in the case of cyber libel in a law called Republic Act 10175 in the Philippines, filed against Maria Ressa and Ray Santos Jr.? It's simple. Let them provide the absolute truth in the court proceedings by providing proofs and evidences to the allegations they wrote about. This, according to Judge Reynelda Estacio Montesaon, they failed to do. Now, since Maria Ressa is undermining the decision of the court and puts the blame on the government of President Duterte for supposedly orchestrating the case in an attempt to silence her, she in effect is denying the complainant, Mr. Wilredo Keng, his own equal protection of the law, guaranteed by the same constitution. In fact, it would have been better and inspiring to the nation and to the Filipino people if, during the court proceedings, Maria Ressa's camp was able to prove point blank the truth to their allegation that Mr. Wilredo Keng was a human trafficker, a drug smuggler, and a murderer involved in the killing of a local politician in 2002. It would have been a relief and a celebration for the Filipino people for a high-profile criminal to land in jail. Unfortunately, their performance was dismal, and all they could show and prove was their malice. And it was unfortunate that the article was written initially not against Mr. Keng and his alleged criminal activities, but rather against former Chief Justice Renato Corona, whose credibility and reputation they were attacking in relation to the 2012 impeachment trial. At any rate, and contrary to the claims of Maria Ressa, democracy is alive and vibrant in the Philippines. In fact, she can still rant at the government for all she likes. Besides, the court decision is not yet final and executory, and that she can appeal to it to a higher court. If she still loses there, then she can bring the case to the Supreme Court. No one is stopping her from doing just that. The thing, however, is she should allow the law to take its proper course and respect it. Finally, all glory and honor belongs to the Almighty God. Dissecting.